Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to take one more sheet metal exercise in SOLIDWORKS, and here we will create this steel bracket with the help of sheet metal tools, and we will learn some basic tools like base flange, fold unfold command, cut command, edge flange, break corner command, and we will see how to save this drawing in 2D format. So let's start to create this simple exercise in SOLIDWORKS. So here let's start to create a simple exercise in SOLIDWORKS with the help of sheet metal tool. Let's click new. Here choose part. Okay, we are going to create a sheet metal part. Background I'll change from here. If you like to change unit, you can simply click here and you will see millimeter, gram, second. Either you can change inches, pound, second, but we will keep millimeter. So here right click and you will see here sheet metal. Now see, the sheet metal tools are here. The first operation we are going to take base flange tab. Either you can directly choose or you can define any geometry, like okay, right plane, I'll say a sketch. Now center point arc, okay, right click. Now here we created. Now either another things we can choose, 3-point arc, then click line and draw vertical line, escape command, or simply press L command in keyboard and you are able to draw a simple drawing. This is construction line. Okay, now let's make select the point tangent. Here also choose point tangent. That's it. Now let's make some relations. Select these two points horizontal. Okay, now mirror entities, these two lines I'll choose, arc and mirror about this line. Okay, now it's mirror. It's time to define the dimensions. 30 millimeter. If you don't want to see this all dimension, simply uncheck sketch relation or either keep, it's up to you, but we will keep so that it identifies for us. Now distance, smart dimension and distance from this 70 millimeter. Okay, corner radius 30 millimeter, and center distance let's say 35 millimeter. Now see, exit and go to sheet metal and choose base flange tab. Now see, it's moving material inside direction 1, blind condition 45 millimeter, but here end condition keep mid plane, so it makes easiness to our geometry. ...45 is enough. Thickness, it's up to you, define whatever you like, let's say 2 millimeter. Corner radius, here see this bend radius, you will define 2 millimeter. K factor 0.5, it is standard, keep as it is, and here no auto relief, so keep as it is. Okay, now the next operation, let's unfold. Let me choose this one. Calculate all bend This is the fixed surface, so we choose here. Other, this all are calculated, this all bendings automatically, no need to select one by one, unfold. Select this face, sketch, normal, and here we will do some little operations. Center point, straight slot, you will find here center point. Okay, now defined it. First the bigger one, 60 millimeter, let's make and the 6 millimeter this diameter, and let's define this length. Six millimeter. This is also 6 millimeter. So let's make a small 3.5 millimeter. Now go to sheet metal, and here you will find option extruded cut. Now here too many closed geometry, so you need in selected contour you use closed body. See, these are the many closed, so you have to select all the closed body here. See, we selected here link to thickness, that means it will cut only up to thickness, no need to define here all the dimensions and everything. Okay, now see. Now let's again choose fold. Now we want to fold it. Now automatically selected phase one, and here collect all bends. Now see, okay, let's do other thing, edge flange. I'll choose this edge, take it out. In the same manner, I'll select this end, this end, it will go opposite side, and the last one this end. Now here in blind condition, here you can, even though you can change radius, but we will keep standard radius 2 millimeter. Angle you can define 90 degree is enough for this. Blind end condition, so 18 millimeter, so that we can easily see all the things. Now here, the distance from outer virtual shark, if you fold like this. Now this second one is bend outside. If you choose inside, see, it's going inside. We will keep bending outside. So bending with radius. Okay. See. Now let's make some more break corner. I'll choose one corner. Okay. So we have to select one by one all the corners. If you choose this face, automatically it will select both the edges. So this is also a good feature. See, so 5 millimeter is enough. We need to make chamfer. That's it. Select this face, and let's try to make some hole here. 7 millimeter distance from here to here, 7 millimeter. Okay, and let's try center center point, connect to this point, right click. Now choose this line and make relation horizontal. Now see, drawing is fully defined. Center line. Make sure it is vertical. Now do one thing, select all, both the lines, click mirror entities. Oh, it is not selected. It's supposed to be, it should be selected here. Click here, copy. Now we copied this whole sheet metal extruded cut. Now here we need to define the length. We can't choose link to thickness because it will cut only thickness. Unchecked, either keep blind or select through all. If you choose through all, it will cut up to end of the outer wall. Okay, see, in the same way we will do some cutouts here also. First we will define center line so that it makes easy for us. Center point is straight slot. Now okay, see, we will see here. Okay, now let's define. Five millimeter. That's it. Now this sketch is fully defined, so simply go to sheet metal and choose extruded cut. Either you can exit, then choose, it's no matter. Simply uncheck this link to thickness through all. If you choose through all, you will see here it's going to cut up to end of this edge. That's it. So this is the simple steel bracket we created in SolidWorks with the help of sheet metal tool. Now we have one option, flatten. If you want to save this flat pattern for AutoCAD purpose, now see, right click and simply export to DXF. Once you click export to DXF, it's going to now save in your any destination wherever you like. It will, we are going to save sheet metal Okay, now you will see this is going to save in 2D format. And this DXF file you can use in AutoCAD or any other software. Save simply. And this is saved as a DXF format in your destinations. Okay. Now, even though, let's try to add some material. Either you can use material, add material from here also, edit material, but I'll prefer to choose this appearance. See, apply, close, see, but I'll prefer to choose steel. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.